Just 90 minutes from Melbourne, Sault Restaurant Daylesford is one of Spa Country's best venues. A stunning property with its own lake, views of the Wombat State Forest, and acres of manicured gardens and lavender fields. It's perfectly suited for weddings and day trips alike.
Hi Jodi, I'm very excited to be spending the day here in Daylesford with you.
Oh, hi Lauren, welcome to Sault. So great to have you.
Now, I believe we're dining inside the restaurant a little bit later on, but first of all, you know the Spa Country better than most and you're going to show me around.
Absolutely. I think the first stop is Hepburn Springs.
Let's go.
The Hepburn General Store is loaded with charm, from the traditional veranda out the front to the selection of quaint products inside. They do brunch, lunch and afternoon tea, and you can't go past one of their yummy toasted sandwiches and some freshly baked sweet treats.
What a cute little place. Is this one of your favourites?
It totally is, and it's just around the corner from my house.
It seems like this place caters for locals and tourists. Is there a bit of everything for everyone here?
There really is. I mean, if you were a local, you can get your weekend papers, get your croissant, get a cake and go home. But if you're a tourist and you want to drop in, they've got everything. Like, you can get your eggs, your local meat, cheeses, some little ceramics from local artist Bridget Bodenham, a wine, local beer.
What more could you want?
Back in Daylesford is Wombat Hill Nursery and Florist. They stock a range of plants that will thrive in Victoria's climate. Plus, you can pick up some honest expert gardening advice or a beautifully styled arrangement while you're here.
This place has been here for like 20 years. It's totally iconic and there's a lot of heart behind this business. So, yeah.
And you have lots of weddings at Sault as well.
We do.
Is this where you direct your brides to come to get all their florals for their wedding?
So they can have a meeting with us, talk about what they're doing, drop in and see Jeff and Donna, get their florals organised, and they know they're just coming from down the road on the day.
And it's so good using local suppliers as well, isn't it?
It really is.
Before heading back to Sault for lunch, we stopped for a cheeky drink at Wine in the Country. Located on Daylesford's Vincent Street, this bottle shop slash wine bar showcases an extensive range of unique wines made by small-scale independent producers.
Now, this is a cosy little spot. If I lived around here, I think I'd be a regular. Are you a regular?
I am. I find it a Sunday afternoon. It's a gorgeous spot to hang out with friends, yeah.
Well, since you're the regular, we've left you in charge of ordering drinks for us. What did you go for?
So I've chosen an Eastern Peak, the Pinot Noir, and then a little gin and tonic for us.
And there's also food on offer.
Yes, so we've got Holy Goat cheese, which is a favourite of mine, and a little local pâté by Max and Delilah.
Oh, yum.
Open for dinner Wednesday through Sunday, with lunch sittings on Fridays and weekends, Sault's menu features regional produce in their seasonally changing modern Australian cuisine.
Jodi, Sault seems to have something new every single time I visit. What are some of the new additions here?
We've got our new 30 garden beds that we're using daily for our chefs to pop out and gather fruit and veggies from.
How much of the produce that you're growing here gets used in the kitchen?
Regularly it's our herbs. The chefs are constantly out here picking and guests love seeing a chef darting out into the garden to put something fresh on the plate. But currently we're using our artichokes, so we've just harvested those and there's a yummy dish that you can try when you head inside. And it's served with holy goat cheese and black truffle from our local truffle farm.
Oh, yum. But it all looks amazing. And what else have you chosen for us?
Well, you're having the duck, and it's served with a little cannoli with duck parfait, pickled carrots from our garden. And then I've got the barramundi with tapioca crisp and fennel from the garden also. Dessert?
Oh, well, I can't stop looking at all that, right, cool. So you better tell us what it is.
So that's the holy goat cheese with the violet gel, violet bubble and violets from our kitchen garden. And then you've got here the mandarin, which is freeze-dried and fresh with a little sage custard.
Oh, amazing. The food looks so delicious and so fresh. But this is more than just a restaurant. It's a bit of a gallery as well. You've got a resident artist.
We do.
You've got some new pieces here.
We do, yeah. James Robertson is an amazing artist based in Mount Franklin. And we've got two of his new pieces in right now. One which is the 18-point turn with the beautiful deer in it and the balloon. And then the other one is the messenger. They're gorgeous pieces.
Stunning, beautiful pieces. Well, thank you so much for having us here at Sault. And thank you for showing me around. I've had a great day with you.
A pleasure, likewise.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Have to do it again soon.
Yay.
If you'd like more information on any of the places Jodi and I visited today, the websites are on screen now.